Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World of Wayne. Something different today, we're going to do a review, an unboxing of the Revell, it's big, SR-71 Lockheed Blackbird. Now you know what, I've been a fan of the SR-71, gosh, since I was a kid. Back in the 80s, there was a film called Daryl, Data Analyzing Robot Youth Lifeform. And right at the end, the boy in it, who is a robot, takes off in an SR-71, which is the most craziest thing you're ever going to see. Also, this plane was the inspiration for the Clint Eastwood film Firefox. The MiG in Firefox was pretty much modeled on an SR-71. Now, I've got two planes which I absolutely love. I love the Vulcan. And I also love this SR-71. And I'm lucky enough to live close enough to Duxford in Cambridgeshire, where they've got both on display. And the first time I actually saw the SR-71 was last year. I've got some pictures here of the one that we have in Duxford here. But I understand there's loads all around the world. And I know that because one of my viewers for Christmas bought me this, which is pretty much an in-depth history and guide to the SR-71. And also with details of every single location of every plane that was ever made, whether it's crashed, destroyed, or it's currently in a museum everywhere. So thank you, Howard DeForest, for that. That's one of my Christmas presents, and this is going to be invaluable for this build, which is going to be coming to the channel later in the year. Now, the SR-71 was developed by the Lockheed Skunk Works division. The first flight took place in 1964. It was an aerial reconnaissance plane. It could operate a Mark 3.2 and a height of 85,000 feet, pretty much why some of the pilots had to wear what looked like spake suits, which allowed it to evade threats. There were 32 aircraft built and 12 of these were lost to accidents. None of these planes were ever lost to enemy action. The plane was retired in 1988, mainly due to the satellite reconnaissance network and the advent of unmanned vehicles. Now, for a good 30 years, I was looking for a model for this and failing abysmally. In fact, I think the only model that I ever saw was this Italieri one, which looks like that. And I apologize if I've butchered the name there. It's a 172 scale. This was sent in by one of my viewers, Howard DeForest, Dash Riptide. Again, the guy who bought me the book. He knows I love SR-71s. Let me just show you what this one looks like so you can get an idea of size difference. Now, I haven't actually opened this one completely at the moment, but as you can see, we've got the decals here, all the instructions, and this is what all the parts look like. Let me just take some of these out. Remember, this is the Italieri kit, the 172 scale kit. All of the parts are in black plastic, as you can see there. Lots of details on the sprue. I think more of this model would be, love the fuselage there, check that out, would be actually the painting. You could do an absolutely brilliant paint job on this one. And I am intending to build both of these. Because I want one in the foreground, which will be this one, which is going to be the smaller one. And then I'm going to have the ginormous Revell one in the background. So that's the Italieri kit. Let me show you the Revell kit. Now, this was kindly a Christmas present by one of my viewers called Ian Longley. Now, this is a 148 scale. Look at the difference in boxes. This is 172. This here is 148. It's absolutely ginormous, and trying to get it on the screen just so you can see it there. Wow, it's big. I haven't opened this one either, so let's open the box and see what we got. Okay, so let's open this up. It's just so big that I don't know how I'm going to get it on camera. Put this on the floor here. And these are the parts here. You know what? I think it's probably going to be best if I actually hold them up to you on the main camera there. Now, obviously, these are going to need priming and painting. The top section actually just comes in the box on top like that, so all the main details for the parts are underneath. So that is ginormous. I can't wait to build this, I'm telling you. This is going to be brilliant. Okay, so let me put that somewhere to one side for a minute so we can see what's underneath here. And these are all the other parts here. Now, I should be able to get these onto the camera, and there are a lot of them. As I said, unlike the other kit, which was black plastic, this is going to need to be primed, which I much prefer because you can get a good lot of depth of color on this. They look just like that. That's the first one, and then this is where the kit's going to come into its own, because the amount of smaller detail pieces, which I'll just show you on the close-up there, is pretty amazing. I mean, look, check out this sprue here of the engines. All the details there. I mean, you're gonna have a field day doing this one. I'm going to have a field day doing this one. I can't wait. I'm just deciding when I'm actually going to put this on the channel, because this is a passion project for me. This is something I've always wanted to build. Now, I am building the 747 SCA with a space shuttle at the moment. So once that's finished, I'm going to be starting work on these SR-71s. But I am just showing you every single sprue here so you can see everything that's on that. Oh God, there's so much detail. This is brilliant. I'm going to move these out the way because we've got to the point now where I've run out of space. But as you can see, there's no stopping the details on this. The amount of sprues this has got, well, it's a little bit overwhelming, I have to say. But there you go. And then we've got this one here. And we've still got more. There's not many clear parts in this build. As you can see, we've only got a couple of sprues of transparent parts. And then the last two sprues, again, a ginormous one there. This one on the top there, looking like that. And then finally, we need a stand to put it on. And that is the stand there and everything in place. And I'm telling you, I mean, look at the size of some of these compared to me. I mean, that's just some of the details. It's almost as big as me. If I bring up that fuselage again, compared to me, look at it. It's absolutely ginormous. I can't wait to build this. Let me just show you some of the decals we get for this. Now, these are the instructions. Lovely and colorized instructions, you can see here, telling you all about how to do decals. Here's the decal sheet. Lots of tiny sections on there. Actually, probably the top camera is the best for that. You've got your tissue, which is supposed to protect them. Let's keep them on top. And then I'm just going to show you through the instructions here. It is pretty comprehensive, telling you exactly where things go. Revell instructions have changed over the years from what I remember. I was having a conversation with one of my viewers, David Howe, about how these have changed since we were kids. But they do go into a lot more detail. They tell you about paint schemes and stuff like that in here as well. And it's pretty comprehensive, the instructions about how we're actually putting all this together. It looks pretty amazing, doesn't it? I'm just flicking through all the instructions there. Making one of the engines. Wow. And then once it's finished, it's telling you on here exactly where each decal goes. And then you've got the bottom view and the side views, just so you can get those completely in the right place. I mean, look at it. Loads of decals on this. And that is the Lockheed SR-71. 40 pages of instructions on that, so that's giving you an idea of how many things there are to do in this. Obviously, this is level 5. This is one of your harder kits, if not one of the hardest kits. But we'll see that for yourself. See, I haven't done many kit models on the channel, and it's something that I really wanted to get into. It's partly the reason why I wanted to do the space shuttle, but obviously when that arrived, we had the Orca, which is what I'm building at the moment. So once the Orca's built, the Lockheed SR-71s is going to be my project. Now, this is pretty much available everywhere at the moment, but there is high demand for it, so it is out of stock. Now, I do want to give a plug to a company called, now I'm going to butcher your name here, and that's Veteranus Hobbies. I don't know the name, to be honest with you. But these were the people that Ian's used to actually send this out to me. And it arrived absolutely perfect and in perfect packaging as well. So I have put a link to their site in the video description as well. As well as some of the other links to some of the other models that you've seen here. But I mean, you can see on my face, this is such a passion project for me. And I can't wait to get it on the channel. I don't know if you've liked these unboxings. This is the first time really I've done something like this on the channel, especially for kit models. So if that's something you'd like to see going forward, then please let me know in the comments, and we'll see what we can do. Just remember, my OCD says if I get one of these, I'm going to be building it. So if I do too many, I'm just going to be snowed under. I think part works will have to take a back seat. I'll be building these kit models. But anyway, I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.